some shied away from fear, I actually thrive on it. My biggest motivation is fear. Fear to fail, fear to fall, and fear to lose. I cannot afford to fail.
Hi, it's Hai Anh, a young Vietnamese woman pursuing legal career to fight against corruptions in the political center of the world, Washington, D.C.
I just turned 25. I'm living my best life, one that many young girls dream of. I've been to, let's see, about 12 countries in total. I've gotten 3 law degrees from 3 different countries. I've been a professional dancer for 10 years. I created my own YouTube channel, Being a One-Man Show. I directed and edited Signified videos for the past 5 years. I'm a memory keeper, a makeup artist, and a performer.
But most importantly, I'm an eldest daughter of an Asian family. If you even know what that means, that means I could probably get 10 more degrees, but that wouldn't even be enough.
Wait. But if all the achievement were taken away from you today, are you really happy with who you are?
Am I going to be happy? I'm not sure.
I was born in May 1997. It was actually a special date in Vietnam, the birthday of Ho Chi Minh, our greatest leader of all time. Ever since I was born, I always have a strong feeling that I was meant to accomplish great things in life. I was raised by a Tiger mom. Her professionalism and discipline greatly influenced me and my character. And my dad, he taught me patience and kindness. Looking up to their success, I set higher standards for myself and everything that I do. Growing up, I didn't attend a typical kindergarten. Instead, my very first friends were orphans in the SOS Children Village. Nurtured by such compassion and empathy, I become more sensitive to other innermost feelings and the injustice around me. I later bring these life materials to light through the lens of my art. I tell the story about children's rights, rape, human trafficking, and depressions through the movement of the body. I was just like any other kid attending a public school. Actually, it's a school for the gifted. I'm a good student. I never try to be the best at studying. What I'm proud of the most is I'm always the leader of pranks in class. I'm really good at connecting, inspiring, and leading people. I believe in the power of teamwork and collaboration.
I was very lucky to meet Hai Anh in high school. We had the best years in high school thanks to Hai Anh. She came up with dances and performances that helped bring us all together. She created so many memories for all of us during high school time that I would never, ever, ever forget.
I might not win on my own, but I know how to lead the group to win. I find joy in helping others succeed. At the age of 18, everyone is eager to be independent from their family. As my friends all left high school and chose to explore the world, I decided to stay close to my hometown and study law. You know, with my personality and creativity, I would rather be in a more upbeat and fast-paced environment. I'm not meant to be in a box. So why law school and why Vietnam? I can use art to raise awareness and touch people's souls. But to bring ideas and words into action, I need law to execute the transformation. I treasure my core values as a Vietnamese and want to learn about my country to the core before reaching out to the world. However, during my times in Vietnam, I often feel like an outliner. In the back of my head, I long for a place that elevates my potential and beyond. Standing between different crossroads and temptations, with all the confusions of my 20s, I didn't know if I'm doing the right things. I feel helpless in front of the tides and ocean that's out there. Still, I choose freedom and choose to extend my potential to the best that I can, even if it takes time.
I've known Hai Anh for almost 10 years now. She's more like a big sister to me. The more I know her, the more I admire, because I have witnessed and I have known things that she has to deal with. I've never expected the person the same age as me has to deal with those stuff. Even though there are things that she may not be proud of herself in the past, but I hope she knows that every single decision in the past has led her to where she is right now and changed her to become such a great person that she is today. I will always be there for her, cherish every single moment of her life.
It took me 6 years to reach that American dream. Moving to Washington, D.C. has forever changed the way I look at life. I had to start with a clean slate. Forgetting my previous entitlement and become nobody in the city was one of the most challenging life experiences that I had to overcome. If being a lawyer is a demanding occupation to any U.S. citizen, that level of difficulty is multiplied by a thousand times being a foreigner. I come to this city, have no friend, no family relative, only two luggage and myself. DC was everything that I imagined it to be, gorgeous architecture and impactful leaders. What I didn't realize is the competitiveness and the thirst for power that lies at the heart of this city. I tried to play catch up with my peers in the master program, but it wasn't enough. How could it be enough? They are all native, and the majority of them have been practicing law for years. Though I have intensive training in this field, I was just a young 24-something, trying to adapt to a completely different culture without any supporting system near me. It was tough and lonely.
The first time I met her, it was in the library, and at the time I was just coming to do my studies and she was also going to do hers. And I have seen another side of her, which I don't think anybody has seen before. That serious face, stressed face, thinking about the studying, what she's gonna do with closed book exams. And one funny fact, that one time I just went to the library, 9 a.m., I found her sitting there 2 hours before me. And 10 p.m. I was going to leave and she was still there. And even it was so funny when she told me, "Are you going to leave and leave me alone?" I'm really so surprised by her personality in that young age. She's really responsible.
On top of catching up with schoolwork, I have to catch up with life. This peer pressure led to many moments where I tried to act mature and forget my true self. I could hardly connect with someone that has been through the same path as me. I feel at odds with American individualism and its hustling culture.
Just like any other international student, like you would have to go through some struggles experiencing the difference between the East and the West. When she first got here, I remember her calling me and asking me for advice, like, how did you adapt to this new culture? And it actually was very hard, especially for someone like Haiyang. She used to work in communities, because here, everyone, they only care of how to position themselves in the spotlight. If you don't fight for yourself, who's going to fight for you?
For the first time in my life, I'm out of my comfort zone. What used to work for me no longer work. Identify crisis, culture struggle, imposter syndrome, I experienced that all.
I will never forget the night she started bursting into tears, telling me about her experience. She was like shaking, crying so much about like struggles that she had to go through in law school. But she doesn't allow herself to give up. She pushed herself to the limit and beyond. She keeps pushing and pushing and pushing until she gets the goal that she wants in life.
So I was trying to do everything at once. I registered for 6 classes each semester. Especially for the last one, it was so hard and stressful because going around talking to people to network and applying for a job. Even my dean flagged me about, like, be aware of your mental health. I'm thinking like my mental is strong enough to convince me that I can go through it all. I'm gonna be fine until it get to my physical health.
I think during the finals period of time where she has so many deadlines, yeah, she texted me one day and she said, I think I have a stomach issue. You know, I was a nurse practitioner before, so I asked her some questions and it sounded like it might be more urgent than something that she can wait another day. I helped her to make an appointment to the urgent care so that she could be seen by a professional on that day.
My stomach is so hurt now, I think because I haven't slept for days, and I'm so stressed now, to be honest. I will graduate by the end of this week, and I still have one more last paper to submit. I'm in a do or die situation, so I really need to graduate this semester. And I still have to work and stay awake. I cannot rest yet.
Haiyan is such a trooper. She never complains, or she never asks for help unless she really needed. You know, we're such like self-efficient people, especially the training that we went through. But when we let other people into our personal lives, you know, we help each other out.
This breakthrough forced me to look within and reframe the narrative about myself. I stopped seeing my background, my identity as a young Vietnamese woman, as a weakness. Instead, it's a pride to lean in. I no longer care about the destination, but more about the journey of self-discovery. By working so hard to overcome the impossibles, I reconnect with the self-confidence and the desire to act for the greater good. It reminds me of Haiyang, who's always believed that she's making an impact in life. I'm so proud of myself. Within only 9 months, not only did I graduate, but I also scored a dream job for myself at the World Bank. Thanks to every single one that I have met and worked with, I've completely outgrown myself. I'm now one step closer to my ultimate goal. Turning 25, turning to the next chapter in life. I'm committed to embracing my national identity, my passion for dancing, my love for art and life. Yes, if those achievements were taken away, I can still make myself happy for keep doing good things in life, being a beautiful artist and a forever learner. For all I know, the whole story is just my beginning.